Welcome to God Level. Your access has been granted.
Yo, it's your mans, Jay Netta, hell of a editor, Rhyme Predator. Welcome back to God Level. Want to give a big shout out to all the new scribers who decided to join us on our way to 100K.
I appreciate you.
Today, we have another one.
Another one.
This is Myron Gaines from Fresh and Fit. I'm not too sure how I feel about him. His personality is kind of but I never met him, so I can't really bring any judgment to him. Never looked him up. Anyway, he has a reality check for black women. Let's get into it.
Comfortable things that might piss some people off, but I'm going to say it. It is what it is. Successful black men, a lot of the time, do not deal with black women.
You can't handle the truth.
That's just the reality. You look at athletes, you look at celebrities, etc. The first thing they, a lot of black men do when they make money is they go and they run and get a white girl, a Latina, an Asian, whatever it is, right? This is the uncomfortable truth that a lot of African-American women dislike, okay? Hmm. Now, what Kevin is doing, contrary to what these, a lot of African-American women think, is he's trying to bring black men and black women together.
Message!
So he's going right into the hornet's nest and telling the black women, this is why you're losing these black men to these other races of women.
Why are you running? Why are you running?
Because here's the reality, and there's empirical data to prove this. Black women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races of women. I'm going to say that again. Black women have the lowest approval rate of all the other races on dating apps. Because they've done it on OkCupid and a couple other dating apps where they looked and said that they saw that black women have the lowest response rates. Now, I know people are saying, well, why is that relevant? I'll tell you why it's relevant. Because on online dating apps, people are brutally honest with what they actually like.
Yes.
That's why the data is so good.
Wow. And I'll say what I think may contribute to that number is the fact that if y'all didn't know, the most obese person in America is literally the black woman. I'm not even fronting. These are facts. Y'all can look the stats up. I'm dead ass. The most obese person in America out of all the races, nationalities that are here, the most obese person is the black woman.
And on top of that, black women, by far, when you look at the numbers, prefer African-American men.
Wow.
Why is this a problem? Well, it goes simple as this. Black men are like the universal blood donor. They'll deal with other demographics of women if they can. Women are blood type A. They can only deal with African-American men typically. That's what they prefer. But the men that they want can date a whole plethora of women versus their what they're looking for is a very segmented portion of the community. Now, let's add some buffers onto that make it worse. Educated black women. Far less likely to get into a relationship than an educated Caucasian woman, okay? Ooh. Black women almost universally don't respect black men.
Uh-oh.
Yup, let me say it again.
You get the point right there.
Almost always do not respect black men. And the reason why, let's keep it real, in the African-American community, a lot of women grow up in fatherless households, right? Their mother tells them shit.
Yep.
The music tells them. Society tells them. So a lot of African-American women grow up in a household where they just inherently don't respect black men.
It's so true what he's saying. I may not agree necessarily with his delivery. It could be coming from a place of malice. But it's true what he's saying. Like, that whole niggas ain't shit, that's what he was saying. But I could say it because I believe we're past 2 minutes in the video. So that whole niggas ain't shit thing is something that we hear in the hood over and over again. Even a lot of times throughout my life when I'm speaking with certain females or I hear my family members talking to each other and one of them might be saying, yo, such and such just broke up. Such and such couple in the family just broke up. Immediately, everybody says, well, what did he do?
And they have more masculine traits because they're raised by a woman that told them you need to compete with men and get out there and get it. The more money a man makes, the more doors open. The more money a woman makes, the more doors close. And for black women, it's even worse because since black women prefer black men, according to the stats, right? The black men that they're looking for that make a certain amount of money, certain height, etc., are literally like a 1%. And all the women want this guy. But guess what? These guys can date Asians, white women, Latinas, etc. Especially these entertainers and celebrities of which these black women are chasing. So what Kevin is doing is this. He's giving them a cold, hard dose of reality that, listen, these men that you're chasing are not looking for you, and society lied to you. This is what you need to do. Here's realistic standards, and this is where you really fall in the sexual market place. Not what you think that you're a 10. This is where you really fall according to men. And then when the women get mad, he tells them, listen, because every woman's defense is this. Well, I have a lot of guys pursuing me, blah, blah, blah. It doesn't fucking matter. How many guys are getting down on one knee and proposing to you? That's when I just hear crickets all over the place. They have nothing to say, just.
So I decided to stop the video right there. For my final word, what I'll say is he was only trying to get across what Kevin Samuels was trying to tell black women, which was simply, this is what you look like. This is what you can attract. And also lower your standards. You go back 50, 60 years ago. Nobody wanted to go on trips year round. Nobody wanted all these expensive bags. Nobody wanted all these expensive cars, especially women. They really only cared about taking care of house and home and the family unit and the support system. We called them matriarchs. Anyway, once again, shout out to all the new scribers who've decided to join us on our way to 100K. If you haven't done so already, hit the subscribe button, followed by the notification bell, all notifications, so that you're notified immediately when I drop new science. And always remember, eye level is God level, y'all level is eye level. Get on eye level, you God level. We out.